Dear friends, a very good morning. Today I will tell you about forms of poetry. You have to know that there are two types of poetry. One is subjective poetry and second is objective poetry. When we talk about subjective form of poetry or subjective poetry, in subjective poetry we find the personality of the poet or the personality of the author. We also find that there is a direct communication between the poet and the reader. When the poet communicates with the reader, he expresses his feelings, he expresses his views directly. He communicates with the reader directly without taking the help of any third character or any third person. If you take an example, sonnet written by John Milton on his blindness, he says, "When I consider how my light is spent." So in the very first line of the sonnet, he uses the word, he uses letter I, and this letter I gives the clue that I means poet himself, because he is talking about himself, his own experience of life. So in subjective form of poetry, there is a direct communication between the reader and the writer. And two, when he communicates with the reader, he uses first person pronoun as I and we. And in objective poetry, the poet communicates with the reader with the help of the third person. We don't find the presence of the poet in the poem directly, but with the help of the third person, third character, using second person pronoun, using third person pronoun, the poet communicates with whom? With the reader. You may take the example, there is a poem Love Song of J. Alfred Prufrock. In that poem, we don't find T.S. Eliot, but instead of T.S. Eliot, there is Prufrock. So broadly we can say that there are two types of poetry. One is subjective form of poetry and second is objective form of poetry. In subjective form of poetry, there is a direct communication between the reader and writer. And when the writer communicates with the reader, he uses first person pronoun, I and we. We find the personality of the poet. We find that the poet is going to communicate with the reader, without taking any curtain, without taking the help of any third person as are using second person pronoun. He doesn't use these things. But instead of these things, he communicates with the reader directly and uses what? And uses first person pronoun, I and we. Lyric comes in the category of subjective form of poetry. Ode also comes. Sonnet comes. Elegy comes. And idyll, I-D-Y-L-L. That's not a poem. That's maybe a piece of the poem. And in objective form of poetry, what comes in objective form of poetry? We find what? We find ballad. We find epic, mock epic, and dramatic monologue. So we remember that whenever we talk about either subjective form of poetry or objective form of poetry, we have to go with these points. In subjective form of poetry, already I told you that writer communicates with the reader with the help of what? With the help of first person pronoun. He uses I and we. Whether you take "When I consider how my light is spent," whether you take "Three a shigri insan and shar, nature said a lovelier flower on earth was never sown, this child I to myself will take, she shall be mine and I will make a lady of my own." Any poem. So overall, I would like to repeat ki when we we talk about forms of poetry, so there are two forms of poetry, subjective form of poetry and objective form of poetry. In subjective form of poetry, there is a direct communication between the reader and the writer. While in objective form of poetry, the writer communicates with the reader, taking the help of the third person character, using second person pronoun or third person pronoun. So this is the basic distinction between subjective form of poetry and objective form of poetry. And next thing I would like to tell you, ki in subjective form of poetry, what comes in subjective form of poetry? Lyric comes, elegy comes, ode comes, sonnet comes, idyll comes. While in objective form of poetry, dramatic monologue, ballad, mock epic, epic, these comes. Thanks. So hope you would like this video also, as you have liked my previous video. Again, I will tell you what is sonnet, what is lyric, what is ode. In my next video, I will define these things.